Welcome to this Autolab video. I'm Alistair Cook and today we're looking at the configuration of VMware Player as the platform for Autolab. This is a really good platform because it is a zero cost, absolutely free virtualization platform. VMware Player installs onto a Windows machine. We need a 64-bit Windows machine and a minimum 8 GB of RAM, so I just fit inside with this machine. The primary configuration that we need to do is to add the networking, the VMnet3 that we use in Autolab. Unfortunately, VMware Player doesn't provide a native user interface. There's no button that you can take that will take you to a network editor. What you need to do is to drill in and find the directory where VMware Player is installed. And in particular, we are looking for the VMnet UI DLL file, which we'll find just here. We need to create a new shortcut. And we need the rundll32.exe to actually launch the shortcut for us. We then want this VMnet UI DLL, which we find in this folder here. So I put in that this is the DLL that we want it to run. Of course, we need to quote it in order to use this path that's got a space in it. And then VMnet UI. .dll, close the quotes, and then we need to name the entry point in the DLL that we want run DLL to use, and it's called VMnet UI underscore show standalone. It is absolutely case sensitive. You must enter it exactly as it appears here, otherwise you won't actually get the network editor. Let's call that the network editor, and so we get a shortcut called network editor. The next thing we need to do is we make that network editor shortcut just run as administrator when we double click the shortcut. Now we can simply double click the shortcut, accept the UAC prompt and say here's our current networking. You'll notice VMnet 0, 1 and 8 are present, which is the defaults. We're going to add VMnet 3. We need a specific subnet in here, so it needs to be 192.168.199.0. The default subnet mask of 24-bit is fine, but we also need to turn off DHCP. This means that the domain controller is going to be able to provide DHCP on the network. We've left in place that the host should be connected to this network, and that will give our workstation machine, our host that's running VMware Player, an IP address on the same subnet. That's all the configuration we need to make to VMware Player. We then need to get ourselves a copy of the Autolab virtual machines. And of course, I always put them in this folder called VMs in the root directory of my C drive. And I go to my network share and I just extract into this folder the zip file containing all of the virtual machines. Once the zip file is extracted, we can also copy in the Windows Server 2008 R2 ISO, remembering that R2, or preferably R2 with SP1, are the supported platforms for Autolab at the current build. Now that the ISO is copied across, we can open up lab local folder, find ourselves the NAS virtual machine, and launch the VMX file, the one with the boxes icon, and that will launch VMware Player for us. Yes, of course, we'll comply with the license agreement. VMware Player is only free for non-production use. As always, when you power on the virtual machines, you'll be asked whether you moved or copied these virtual machines, and you simply say that I copied it. Safest thing, generates a new MAC address, and we're away powering on the virtual machine. As usual, after a few minutes, the NAS virtual machine will start up and be ready to use. From there, you can move on to populating the build share and starting to build the domain controller and then the ESXi servers and vCenter server. One trap to be aware of is that VMware Player version 5 seems to be the last version of VMware Player that includes that VMnet UI DLL. And consequently, we haven't yet found a way to get a network editor for version 6 of VMware Player, which is the current release. We're working on it. We'll come back to you. This has been the Autolab video on configuring VMware Player for Autolab 1.5. I'm Alistair Cook, and you should keep checking the labguides.com website and watch out for us some more on YouTube, particularly that video about populating the build share.